Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got another question here about contradictions. This is good. I love when people tell me about contradictions or seeming contradictions because, you know, life is full of contradictions. In fact, you know, when I went to one of the best things when I went to acting class, one of my acting instructors, he told me, he said, you know, if you want to play a character, you have to embrace contradictions. People are often angry and happy at the same time. They're often two like contradicting things, sad and happy, you know, whatever it is. And that's what true emotion is. That's what reality is actually a lot of contradictions. So there are a lot of contradictions in life. And so, you know, things are not black and white, right? So when we try to sometimes say, oh, it's always this or it's always that, or this is a set of rules that defines things, we miss the mark or we create something that doesn't feel quite real. It feels fake. And so that's reality. So it's good, you know, to talk about contradictions and to even to contradict yourself from time to time, because it, you know, two different extremes kind of, you know, a lot of times I'll see people that have two different paths in life, that total different philosophies, and they'll both reach success, even though they're totally in conflict with each other. But how does that happen, right? So it's important to look at things and to have that open mind. So anyway, with that said, this question is from Paul. And Paul says, I'm enjoying reading your soft skills book, and I have a question. In the chapter about the Pomodoro technique, you wrote that you aim for 10 Pomodori a day or 50 to 55 Pomodori a week. You also linked to a blog post about the mathematician Henri Poincaré, who only worked 4 hours a day in deeply focused state. On the other hand, a few chapters later, you wrote, if you truly want to succeed, if you truly want to be successful, you're going to have to pull some all-nighters. You might have to spend a few years of your career doing 60 to 70 hour weeks. That advice seems conflicting to me. Could you clarify what you believe is optimal? Thank you, Paul. So yes, that does seem conflicting. I agree. There's a couple of things here. Well, first of all, let's just kind of look at and kind of dispel the notion of the timing of how much time that I actually spend when I advocate doing 50 to 55 Pomodori a week, or let's say 10 a day. So let's say 10 Pomodori a day, right? You know, again, quick recap: Pomodoro technique, 25 minutes you work, you know, 5 minute break. So 10 of those a day would actually be 10 periods of 25 minutes of focused work. And if each one, including the break, takes half an hour, so 10 is actually like 5 hours worth of work per day, of solid work, right, of focused work. In an 8 hour day, I'm only working 5 hours if I'm working 8 hours of focused work, right? There's obviously overhead and other stuff that you're doing, but that's a really hard thing to accomplish. That is actually working hard. So most people, right, if you actually track your time, if you're trying to do this, if you go to your job and you track how much time that you spend on focused, deep focused work on a thing, it's probably gonna come to honestly like 2, 3, maybe 4 Pomodori, honestly, like, do this and check this out. So, and if you try to do 10 in a day, you're gonna realize that doing 5 hours of solid, uninterrupted, focused work is very, very, very taxing and hard, and probably harder than you've ever worked before. So that is very, very hard. And that's pretty close to, remember, you know, you said that I said Henri Poincaré only worked 4 hours a day in a deeply focused state. That's pretty close to that right there. So 5 hours or 4 hours. And honestly, like if I do 10 Pomodori, some of those are like easy ones, right? Are not really super deeply focused state, right? If I do 8 of them that are in a deeply focused state, that's doing pretty good. That's hard, and that's right at 4 hours. So that, I think there's really this natural limit. I think that about 4 hours of solid, hard work, like focus work in a day, is about the max that a human being can really accomplish, like over the long term, and actually be productive. There's a bunch of other stuff you could do. You could always like do busy work and administrative stuff and answer emails and whatnot, but that's not deep focused work. Most writers, in fact, I can think of so many of them. Stephen King, right? He writes 4 hours a day. I've talked about Isaac Asimov before. Same thing. He wakes up at the crack of dawn. He writes till about 12. So it probably comes to about 4 hours. I think Nora Roberts, I read about her, and she's written how many hundreds of novels. It has a similar approach where she writes so many hours a day. So yes. Yes, I am saying work really, really hard. Yes, I am saying only work about 4 to 5 hours of focused work, and they're not a contradiction, because that's pretty much, most of us are really working like 1 hour of focused work in a day, if even, especially if you're in a corporate job, like just chart your time, and I talk about that in soft skills. So to kind of address the other point of this, like when I said, if you truly want to succeed, you've got to work some 60 to 70 hour weeks, and you got to be able to pull some all-nighters, and you might have to do that for a few years. That's totally true, right? And then that might be at the same time, right? This might not, but there's also this other element I wanted to discuss here that you're bringing up, which is this time element, right? So a lot of people will tell you, don't work so hard. Work smarter, don't work hard, right? And usually those people that are saying that, they're really successful, so we take this advice really, as this must be it. And what those people often forget is they forget those years where they went through the drudgery, where they busted their butt trying to get to where they got to. Because now, once you've built a thing, once you have momentum, once this ball is rolling down the hill and it's picking up speed, then you can kind of relax, right? Because the ball's taking itself. So you don't have to work as hard. Then you can work smart. Then you're like, why am I killing myself anymore? I don't need to. And you start getting the same results. In fact, you start getting better results as that ball's picking up momentum, and you forget that you pushed the ball up the hill. You forget all that work. So don't listen to those people. Even though they're super successful, it's because they've forgotten. They've forgotten what it's like. And that's why I say it might take you 3 to 4 years of bussing butt. I had to, right? I mean, I did Pluralsight courses while I was working a full-time job. I was working my 8-hour-a-day job. Then I was coming home, spending some time with my family, eating dinner, and then I was working 4 to 5 hours every single night for over 2 years, right? And working on weekends. And that's what it took to push my ball up the hill. Once I got that stone all the way up that hill, now it's on cruise mode. Now I don't have to work as hard if I don't want to. I still, maybe I do kill myself a little bit more than I should, but that's the key, is right. It does take sacrifice. Like I don't know of anyone that just kind of like breezed into it. That's like, I've been working smart my whole life. I've only ever put in 20-hour weeks and I reached this high level of success. And it just doesn't happen. Almost all stories, even those people that say, man, stop working so hard. You got to work smart. And I only work 4 hours a day. Yeah, but let's go back in time, and like if you ask them and say, okay, tell me how you got started and tell me about the, almost always you're gonna find 2 or 3 years of their life where they just hated life, where they just busted their butt, they're on the verge of a nervous breakdown, and then they made it through, and that's how they became successful. So hopefully that helps you. I'm glad you brought this up, because this does seem like contradicting advice, but it's like I said, there's the two elements to it. There's the one of realizing that doing 10 Pomodori a day is actually quite a bit of work, and also that there's a time element, different points in your life. And I like that analogy, just think about pushing a stone up a hill, right? There's a time when you got to do that, and then when it's rolling back down on the other side, it's got its own momentum. It's taking you forward. You don't have to work as hard. You don't have to put in 60-hour weeks for the rest of your life. You just have to do it until you get that stone all the way up that hill, so that it can take itself down. So thanks again for the question. If you've got a question, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And as always, subscribe to the channel, and you'll get 3 new videos like this every week. Take care.